Greetings and salutations of peace from the Underground News Network. I am the Rastafari Itol Imani. The basics of being a Rastafari is not known to many who practice or emulate. First, we must establish what Rastafari is and its function in the cycle or scheme of life. A Rastafari is one who woke up. Like the Buddha, he became the Christ. It was his title. This is the objective of the seeker on the path to truth, which leads to the mountain which sits the Rasta man, the enlightened one. The symbol of this attainment is the King Haile Selassie, the black man. The black man in America woke up to this realization, the symbol King Haile Selassie. He chose an example which looked like him as Christ, the black man did. So Selassie is a symbol, not the God to be worshipped. He came from a long line of gods, as we all do. We all have the potential to obtain or reach. The student starts learning, traveling, fasting, changing his diet, becomes a vegetarian, cleans his blood, he becomes pure, raises his life force. His mind is open as a result of this. After many years of practice on the path of life, the few from the chosen become Rastafari, king of himself. He is now the self-governed. There are certain basic sensitivities not picked up by ones who say they are Rastafari today. They are not in tune with the ancient Maya calendar, the galactic underworld. They do not have a total scope of our knowledge. They did not go through the full curriculum of the Rastafari Mystery School. And there are those who are lost in ritual. They are the priest, the Rastafari in Jamaica. Perfect example, the Bobo Ashanti. They are the priests, like the Ethiopian monks in the hills of Lalabala. They go through rituals. They are the priest. They are not Rastafari. All are not enlightened beings. You are now in tune on the one, the force itself. At this time, we call it the Master Blaster Jamin. Those who are lost in ritual, they believe or think Selassie is God, the creator of heaven and earth, and men and women, and all things. This is of the conflict of the Rastafari movement. We travel by the Spirit, through the Spirit, to reason, uncovering our glory which falls down upon us from heaven. The chalice is passed counterclockwise through the path of time to God, who speaks to us. When the Spirit has gone, we gather our locks, hiding our wisdom from the world, and travel in the Spirit back into the world of the mundane to transform it. It has been noticed that Rastafari is Zen passive. We are in the world, but not of the world. We do ordinary things like chopping wood, carrying water, working in the garden, but we do it not in an ordinary way. It is the Zen-like quality of Rastafari which transform the world. This passivity transforms the world. We move among the ordinary, transforming it. We speak without words. You are now in tune. On the one, the force itself at this time, we call it the Master Blaster Jamming. Concern the whites who wish to be Rastas, we say that Rastafari is a black revolutionary movement, but each man is free to serve God as he chooses. So we tell you to look at this closely. Rastafari is a sacred rite, is a sacred order. It is a spiritual science of the black man, which is esoteric. It is as a fellowship. So ones who see us and emulate us have the right to do so. But door peep shall not enter while the wise and true man stand sipping from the cup of peace. You are now in tune. On the one, the force itself at this time called the Master Blaster Jet. The Master Blaster Jamming.